What up, world? It's your boy DJ Primetime, and you're watching Out the Box. Welcome, your host, Roj!
Right here on Out the Box. Today, we're focusing on mental health, and we have some special guests in the building. My girl, Erica Woodard from Wellstone, and also some spoken word from my man, Chill City. So you want to keep it locked right here. We got it going on. It's Out the Box. Welcome back to Out the Box. You're being Roj. My first guest today is my girl Erica Woodard with Wellstone. Today we're kind of focusing on mental health. Now, first of all, let me know a little bit about this new program you guys got going on at your job.
Okay. So the program is called First Episode Psychosis Program. So basically what we're doing is we're talking to individuals. We're providing support for individuals ages 15 to 25 who have experienced their first episode of psychosis. So we go in, we have the therapy, and I'll be doing the therapy. We have a nurse practitioner who's providing medication. We have a nurse on staff. We also have peer and family support to give support to the family and give support to the individual to kind of help them guide them along through all this. And we also have employment and education specialists. And this person is designed to just help the person to stay on their regular life path with whatever educational or employment goals they may have. And we also have a care coordinator to just help to link them to resources in the community.
Okay, well, you know, recently everybody's been on this train acknowledging, for one, mental health days, just mental health in general, because for the longest generations have just been like, go to church. How important do you feel that this movement is now that people are finally acknowledging that mental health and mental illnesses are real?
I think it's so important, and I'm so glad that now we are acknowledging. Yes, you can go to church. Yes, you can pray about it, but we also have to put things in action. We also have to take steps for ourselves. We need support. We need our families to be there to say, I'm with you. This is scary. This is not just scary for the individual. This is scary for families. Most of the issues that come along with mental illness aren't the mental illness symptoms of the mental illness themselves. It's from the stigma and the isolation that comes along with it. Not being able to ask for help. Not being able to say, I have things going on that I need to have addressed. So now that we are waking up and we are starting to acknowledge that mental health is real, mental health issues are real, it's a good thing. So now people can start asking for help and seeking the support that they need.
Okay, we definitely got to get away from the stigma that is a bad thing to ask for help. Just tagging the name mental illness to anything, people kind of shy away from it. But I think it's very important myself where, you know, you kind of take time out for yourself, because if you don't take care of yourself, no one else will, right?
This is true.
All right, so how can people get in touch with you? Big team playing, big team playing. All right, if you guys have been tuned in, you know what that means. It's time to play a game called Out the Box, right? Mental health and just therapy and all that stuff is very serious. She's even dressed up real serious right here. So we're gonna play the game. I'm gonna get her out of her comfort zone, and we're gonna see what PT pulls out the box. And I just want, you know, I think dancing is therapy, so I just want to keep dancing. Just a little bit. Just a little bit.
Just a little bit.
Let me see.
You want to see me?
Yeah, come on.
Hey.
That's all you got. can get in tune with her program, you can head to the website, outtheboxtv.com, for more. And hey, thank you for coming by today.
Thank you.
All right, we'll be right back. Out the box.
According to the World Health Organization, more than 264 million people of all ages suffer from depression globally. Now, it's also the world's leading cause of disability. Now, there's no single cause of depression, according to research. Brain chemistry, hormones, genetics, life experiences, and physical health can all play a role. Now, I wanted to dive a little deeper into the subject, so I dropped in on Tobia Cook from Inner Healing Counseling to gain some insight. Now, I've had a few friends reveal to me after they overcame some of their battles that they suffer from either anxiety or depression and wondered what are some signs we should look for so that we are able to recognize depression in our friends and family members.
We sometimes think that in order for you to be depressed, you have to lay in bed all day or not want to clean the house. It is obvious. But then there are those who are literally suffering in silence and not saying anything, but they're dying on the inside and they're suffering from depression, but they're living a normal day-to-day life. So how do you detect depression in these types of individuals? Well, it can present in different ways. Some people lose interest in the things that they used to enjoy. Some people kind of withdraw from others. So although they may be functioning as normal going to work, they may go home when they come home from, you know, they may go home after work, not really socialize as much as usual. You may hear them say, well, I'm not really interested in doing that anymore, or that doesn't make me happy anymore. They're not as fulfilled. You kind of listen to see, is there hope? Do they have hope for the future? That is one of the key things that you look for in a person that has depression. Is there hope? Can they see the future? Do they dream? Do they have aspirations? Do they have goals? Or are they just existing?
How do you feel about the movement that is now taking place in our community when it comes to acknowledging that mental health is actually a thing?
As a practitioner, I can say that I am pleased that more people are having these types of conversations. You know, like, my goal is for it to become the norm. You know, that's the idea. I would like for, if someone was struggling with their mental health, it to be just as normal as it would be if they were going to the doctor for a sore throat, instead of, you know, it being frowned upon. But I am happy that a lot more people are bringing awareness to mental health. A lot more people are accepting that it is okay to get help in whatever capacity you see fit. You know, if you don't want to talk to a psychologist or a psychiatrist, you know, you have other options. You have counselors, you have life coaches, you know, you have support groups. So it's not just sitting on a couch, you know, pouring your heart out. There are several avenues in which you can take care of your mental health. And I am very pleased that we are now at a point where we can have these conversations.
Unfortunately, there's still a stigma that surrounds mental health issues, and some people view disorders like depression as a weakness. Now, do you think we make it harder on ourselves to get help that may be needed because of this stigma?
We make it hard on ourselves, but then society adds another layer to the difficulty it is to just go ahead out and reach out for help. So let's say I was thinking, well, I really need help, but I'm kind of afraid. Let's call my friend and see what she says. If my friend tells me, girl, you don't need to talk about that, don't tell your business to a stranger, now you've added another layer. Because had I had a friend or someone in my corner who could tell me, no, it is okay, I have talked to a counselor, I did find this beneficial, I'm more likely to say, okay, well, let me give this a try. Someone else has tried it and it wasn't that bad, so maybe I can do this. But until it is normalized within society and more people are doing it, you know, that will kind of help with that internal battle to reach out for help.
What is one thing you hope to see take place this year in regards to mental health?
I just would like for counseling and taking care of your mental health to be the norm.
We must continue to make this a part of our conversation. Take those mental health days. Reevaluate, refresh, re-energize. Whatever is necessary, make sure you're taking care of yourselves. This segment of Out the Box is brought to you by Bama Elite Security and Training, learning from our past to protect our future.
All right, we're back right here on Out the Box, and we got our performance today. Spoken word artist with my man Chill City. What it do?
Peace, Chill City, man. Please don't forget the pound sign, please.
Pound sign. All right, it's there.
Let's run it.
Let me know how long you've been doing this.
Man, I've been doing music, not just spoken word, but spoken word, hip-hop, R&B, pop, G-funk, for about 10 years, man. It's kind of been on and off until like the past 6 years. Just released a major single, Divine Intervention, which is out now on YouTube, all major media streaming platforms. Just follow me, pound sign Chill City.
That's how it goes down. Well, tell me a little bit about Red Cardinal Effect.
All right, yeah, solid. So Red Cardinal Effect is really geared towards the community. What we do is we partner with healthcare professionals, healthcare facilities, and not only just create incentive-based programs for individuals whose insurance may not cover them going to see a chiropractor, covering them to go see a naturopathic physician. What we do is create incentive programs to where you can still afford it, even though your insurance may not cover it, and it's beneficial, it's holistic. It cuts the needs of pharmaceutical drugs, which saves money. So it's really geared towards putting money back into the pockets of the community, as well as supporting these local businesses.
All right, that's what's up. Well, it's time. Let's make it happen right here, my man. Pound Sound, Chill City.
Please,
let's do it.
Pound Sound. Blessing. This piece right here, man, is called Stains. You can actually find this on YouTube, man. Search me on all major media platforms, Pound Sound, Chill City. This is a living testament, man, if you will. Real vulnerable, man, so y'all bow with me.
Quarter six, stand
up.
I was conceived by Jackie Jordan. My father was Timothy. Now I'm the sycamore trees. Let's go down 6 or more feet. Deathly Child, Deathly Hollows was the story about me. Scars like Harry Potter, but they dots on me. Scarred after the fact that my dad left me. Barred from all the facts that I could not see. It's hard dealing with facts when it's dad you see. Now broad woke to the back, cause now it's them I see. They say you never really miss it till it's dead or it's gone. Well, you can never really miss it when it don't come along. My favorite wishes was for kisses and my dad to come home. Put my mom through hell and she did it all on her own. My black arts grew black and dark. My demeanor is now an art. Flow is acapella, but still they give me a beat. The sorcerer's stone must be alive in me. Trial and error built me better far as eyes can see. Hold on.
Chill City. Cousin. This middle school right here. Listen,
had to let it breathe for a minute. See, I was the timid kid that had to leave for a minute. So nervous I had to piss and hit the lid when I finished. Got a little on my leg and couldn't leave for a minute. In the bathroom, pissy and dirty, I could not catch a break. The girl I was dating sent the note saying mistake in the date. I'm sorry for 2004, this won't work for me anymore. George Floyd, you cute and all, but I need you to do more. You don't hold my hands, you never buy me candy. I heard you pissed your pants, now we can't have that, can we? Add it on to the fact, cause the fact is, baby, you're a good guy, and good guys finish last here lately. You see, I blow tops like blow pop, you ain't with that, baby. You ain't knocked off, so get lost, get a throwback, maybe. You come off too soft, and I just want my top off, but you can't lift that. Don't find the switches, so boy, just get back. Damn.
Y'all, no lie, man. My middle school years was horrible. Horrible. But still, shout out to Ed White, though.
Chill City, this high school. Listen. My growth came, but my gross ain't changed. So now it's high school with no name. Same. Dirty demeanor in them piss stains. Gay. Can't ask her out, not in these chains. I blame all of my family, it is history. I stayed away from parties, I had no dates. I'm saying, 3 girls in 3 times, I got played. Amazed, like what I'm doing can't be my fate. Now that I'm older, I dish the cold and shoulder. You can't defrost that. Women hit my line and in their minds, I take them back. Seasons change, the depth in a different mind frame. In my memory bank, I wouldn't admit that I've changed. No, I don't know that guy, I know that his friend. And we can't hang like that. You are not my kin. It sucks to be like that. I can't let you in. It's 100 more snakes that's trying to get in. Chill City. Yeah.
One more time.
sign for my man Pound Sound Chill
please,
City.
Please don't forget the pound sign.
Don't forget the pound sign. I appreciate you for coming through. You guys know what to do. Head to the website outtheboxtv.com for more information on my man right here. And hey, we'll just catch up with you guys next week right here for another episode of Out the Box. Let's go.
Peace.